Welcome to a short training video designed to introduce you to the different tools and features found in Google Earth. These training videos are designed to assist you in creating and presenting your information to others in a geographic context. This video is part 8 in the series, where you'll be learning the different methods for saving, sharing, and presenting your project. Saving your work as you go is of great importance when working in Google Earth. This process is very easy. Simply go to the File menu, select Save, and Save My Places. This will save everything currently contained within the My Places window and can be returned to at a later time. In addition, Google Earth also offers the Save Places As function, which will create a KMZ that you can take with you when you are finished. This is especially useful if you are working on public computers or moving to different computer stations, as your work is saved in one easy-to-access file. Sharing your project with others is also easy, as Google Earth offers three methods for sharing your work. The first is an email function, which will allow you to send either a JPEG file of the current view that has no interaction, a snapshot that sends a file that will open the current view in Google Earth with no data, or an entire folder that will send a KMZ file recognized by Google Earth that can be downloaded, emailed, or made available on the internet. If you're interested in sharing your data or allowing others to contribute to your work, I recommend saving your project as a KMZ, which will also make loading the project within a web page using tools such as embed gadgets much simpler. If you prefer a printed map rather than a digital image, Google Earth offers the ability to print high-quality images or descriptions of the locations included in your project. Simply navigate to an area that interests you and select the Print button. Ultimately, you can create a wide variety of projects to share with others. Your projects do not have to rely on just points, lines, and polygons either. Many different types of data and information can be presented using Google Earth. It only becomes a matter of discovering a way of presenting and accessing your information efficiently. For additional project ideas, I encourage you to review the Earth Gallery, which has projects from multiple disciplines posted by individuals of the Google Earth community for viewing and inclusion in your project. This concludes Part 8 and the concluding section of this series. To learn about additional features and functions and how to apply them within Google Earth, please refer to the additional tutorial videos found in this series. Thank you for viewing this podcast and for your interest in Google Earth.